Hey, Jessica.
Oh, hey, Catherine.
I got these sketches from Andrea. Do you want to check them out?
Sure.
What do you think?
Wow, they look really good.
Yeah.
Man, so I'm liking all of them, but maybe we shouldn't use this first one here.
Why not? Splash screen.
Well, in Android, we generally don't like using splash screens. Instead, we jump directly into the app content so that the user doesn't have to wait for the splash screen to load.
Oh, okay. How did you know that?
Well, it's covered in the material design guidelines.
Oh, yeah. Kunal and I totally covered that in the last course. The students know that spec front to back. Hmm. But you know, knowing the spec is different from actually applying it. So I think we could really use some design help.
Ooh, actually, I'm glad you bring that up.
Oh,
so
okay.
I know this amazing team of designers. So they can take our ideas, the features that we like, and create some beautiful mocks for us.
That sounds amazing.
Yeah. So how about I'll take these sketches to them,
okay.
Get some mocks back, and meet with you later.
OK, thanks.
All right, see you soon. So when you first open the app, we see a list of categories: numbers, family members, colors, and phrases. If you click on the numbers category, it shows a list of numbers. And for the number one, we have the English and Miwok words, as well as an image and a button to play the Miwok pronunciation aloud. And the same applies for the family, colors, and phrases categories. So phrases such as "what's your name" and "how are you feeling" don't really have an intuitive image to go along with them. As a result, we decided to show the English and Miwok translations with the option to play the sound as well.